Hi, I'm Jay Sellers with the Brunswick-Glynn Joint Water and Sewer Commission. You likely know that we take providing safe and clean water for you and your family very seriously. However, did you know that we give the same level of care to the treatment of the wastewater that leaves your home or business? Let's dig deeper together here to learn more about what we do to make your sewage safe to return back to the environment. Not to be confused with storm sewer, the sanitary sewer system in our service areas discharge to one of three plants. The Academy Creek plant for mainland Brunswick, the Southport plant for the I-95 exit 29 area, and the Dunbar Creek plant for St. Simons Island customers. You may notice that two of these plants are so named because of their outlet into the river they are located adjacent to. Let's talk about the efforts that we take to ensure that what gets to the river is safe for the sensitive ecosystem. Wastewater comes to us from homes, businesses, schools, and industries. According to the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, the average American produces 100 gallons of wastewater each day. As the name implies, wastewater is mostly water. In fact, wastewater typically averages 99.94% water by weight. Only a small amount, 0.06%, is actually waste material. So what makes up this small percentage of solids? Aside from the most obvious, human waste, our daily activities contribute many other water pollutants, including food particles, paper products, dirt, oil and grease, proteins, organic materials such as sugars, inorganic materials such as salts, personal care products, pharmaceuticals, cleaning chemicals, and hundreds of other chemicals. Though they may look complex from a distance, treatment plants are designed to accomplish one basic goal: to produce a stream of clean water that is safe to return to the environment. The processes within our plants act much like the process that naturally occurs in a stream or lake. Bacteria and other small organisms living in the water feed on waste. While consuming this food, the organisms eliminate waste and produce new bacterial cells, carbon dioxide, and other products. Our plants use the same process by intentionally introducing bacteria and organisms to consume waste. We just monitor it very closely and speed it up a little. The capacity and flow of the local treatment plants is surprisingly high, measured in millions of gallons per day. There are four steps to our treatment process. Preliminary treatment consists of using a bar screen to remove excess solids, especially trash. This step helps remove many of the things that could clog pipes and disable treatment plant pumps down the line. If you haven't heard it before, now's a good time to say that toilets are not trash cans. What you flush will get caught at the beginning of our treatment process or get removed along the way, adding expenses to the process that increase our operating costs unnecessarily. Secondary treatment takes place in the next step of the process, where aeration and sedimentation tanks, known here as aeration basins and clarifiers, expose the wastewater to an activated sludge process where microorganisms are essentially activated by bubbling oxygen through the mixture to help motivate the bacteria to eat up any remaining organic matter in the process. The carbon dioxide and methane released during this process is what often gives the plant their distinctive odor. At the end of this process, 95 to 99% of the waste has been removed from the flow of water. During the advanced treatment process, filtration methods are used to remove specific toxic substances that may be present in the water stream, such as excess nutrients like phosphorus and nitrogen, which can upset the balance of oxygen necessary to sustain life in the river. Finally, the wastewater is disinfected using chlorine plus ultraviolet light in some cases before the water is returned to the river. This disinfection significantly reduces any remaining bacteria and viruses and helps protect the wildlife from exposure to potentially pathogenic microorganisms, things that can make the local fish sick. After the 6 to 8 hour trip a drop of wastewater takes through the process, it can be safely returned to the environment. Supporting this process are the 26 wastewater treatment operations staff, dedicated men and women comprised of state licensed lab analysts and treatment operators, plant maintenance mechanics, and technicians that help guarantee that what is flushed can be adequately, safely, and cleanly processed 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days out of each year. You can rest assured that our team is working around the clock to keep what you flush flowing. Every day, the staff of the JWSC is here to serve you.